Welcome everyone. Today we are going to talk about web scraping, or you can say kind of web automation that we are going to perform using simple script in our browser itself, and we are going to code this thing in JavaScript. Okay, so before we start automating this application, let's have a look at the kind of information that we have available on this page. Okay, so you can see a lot of machinery parts, their title and their prices and their description on the page. And if I scroll down, you would see that there are around 500 products. How I would able to know that there are 500 products? That I can see in the URL itself, where the parameter n equals 500. Now, the interesting part of this is, by default, when I go to this category on this website, they show only 10 products on one page. Okay, so the value that comes by default here was n equals 10. Right, and then they have a pagination below the page, and I can go to second page to see the next 10 results, and then third page to the next 10 results, and so I can move forward to extract all the information. Now, if I need to automate it in this way, I would be taking a lot of time, or I need to write a lot of code to first extract 10 elements and then navigate to next page and then extract more elements and then navigate further, right? So you need to make your problem statement easy while doing web scraping. It is not just about automation. It is about how you extract the data in a faster way, right? So it is just a query string parameter, and they don't have any check to limit the number of results. So I manipulated this value of n equals 500, and I was able to see 500 products. And I'll hit and try. I'll put 1000 and 2000. So if I would be able to see all the products, I would count that as the maximum value of n, right? So ultimately, I'll be having all the elements or all the machinery parts available on one single page, and I can write a simple piece of code in the browser console itself to extract all this information in one go. Now let's have a look how we can use console to extract this information. Right, so once we have the page ready and we have all the elements visible on one page, let us start identifying each block for these 500 elements, and then we'll be digging down inside to extract the title and the prices. Alright, so we can see here it is list element, and the parent is UL unordered list, whose class is product list, row list. And if I move the mouse on the list item, you can see here this list item. When I click on the first one, it highlights the first one. When I go to second one, it highlights the second one. Alright, so I need to identify these list elements. So for that, I need to use the parent so that I can use index to identify which child I am referring to. So to go to the parent, the unordered list, I use document.querySelectorAll, and then I'm using the class property. So I use dot product list, and I need to replace all the spaces with dot, so dot row dot list. And this gives me that the length of this is 1. That means only one such element is present on the page, which is matching the criteria. I can either use the index 0 to get to the first element, which is this unordered list, or I can use query selector method instead of query selector all to reach to that element or that unordered list. Okay, now we need to dig down further. Inside this, we need to select all the list elements. So I further use dot query selector all and li. Now you can see here we have all the list elements here, and it shows that node list has 500 elements. So this entire set of elements you can save in a variable. You can use var elements equals document.querySelectorAll and this selector. So you have all the elements in this variable elements. So now you can type elements here and see the value of elements, and it shows that it is having list of 500 elements. Now to access one of the elements of this list, so what you can use is you can use the index. So for example, if you give the index in square brackets as 0, that means the first element. If you give 1, that means the second element. So you can see here the highlighted one is the second one actually. Alright, similarly if you put 2 here, that means the third element. So index starts with 0. So that means if we have 500 elements, the last index would be 499. Now the next task is that we need to iterate through each of these elements one by one, and from this element block we need to get the title and price for every item. Okay, Let's find the locators for the title and the prices. So we inspect here, we see here that it is a H5 tag, and inside that we have an anchor tag whose class is product name. So let's say I want to access the first element, so elements with index 0 dot query selector, because we further want to extract an element which is anchor tag, so a dot, and the class name is product name, so I put the class name here. So this would give me that particular element, because I know only one element is there, so I'm using query selector method. And if I need the text for this, so I can use dot inner text. Now one problem here is that in this inner text you can see here dot 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 in the end, that means the name is not complete, but when you mouse over you see the complete name, so that means it is present somewhere in the HTML. If we further dig down, you can see here it is present inside the title. So instead of inner text, you can use the title here. So that would give you the complete name. Okay, so we'll be using this for all the elements. Right now we are using for index 0. We need to use it for all the indexes 1, 2, 3 till 499. And we can check for 499. It is filter area break. And we can scroll down to the last element and see whether this is the right one or not. And here we go to the last element, and yes, this is the right element. Okay, so we need to use a for loop here to increment our counter from 0 to 499, and then we'll be using this statement to extract all the titles here. So to use the for loop, you can use the syntax for I equals 0 until I is less than 500, or it is better that you use elements.length to make it dynamic, and then I plus plus, and then you need to use a curly braces, and inside the curly braces you need to use console.log to print your output on the console, and then it ends with semicolon. And the line or the statement that we have written earlier, I'm just putting here inside the console.log. So elements at index I am replacing that 0 with I here, because I want to make it incrementing according to the loop counter. So query selector a dot product name dot title. So it ends with a curly braces, and let's run it. So if I hit enter, there is something wrong. Yes, the issue is in the spelling of this length. So I correct the spelling and run this piece of code again. So we have this elements.length now. And let us run it for 5 elements for now. Let's see the 5 titles, and then we can run it for all the elements. So for 5 it worked absolutely fine, and if I change it to elements.length, it should give us all the titles. And here we have. So we can copy down all the results and paste in Excel. Now we need to use the same strategy to extract the prices. Let's say we want all the prices in column B. So we first inspect the element for the price. So I go to inspector and I click on one of the prices, and I can see here it is a span tag, and the class is price product price. Okay, so we can go to this console, and then for the first element, elements with index 0, I can use again query selector, and in the locator I can give span dot price dot product price. Okay, so this way I can reach to that element, and I can further use dot inner text to print the price value. So if I run it for first element, you can see here it is 13.29 pounds. So we can check for the last element as well, which is 22.57. okay, so we can check here also, and this is correct. Now let us again use the for loop and put this statement inside the for loop, and we will be parameterizing the counter here as an index. So I equals 0 and I less than elements.length, I plus plus, and in the console.log I put that statement, and then here instead of 499 I'll put I. Okay, now when I run this, I get an error here in between. It says that cannot read a property inner text which is null. That means you can see here above we also have some of the results, but for one of the elements it gave us error. So that means there is one element present in between these 500 which is not having this particular element, and it was not able to fetch the inner text for that. Okay, so it is important that you put a check here that if that element is present, only then try to extract the inner text of it. So I have spotted that element, and you can see here for this particular block we don't have any price, okay, and in the code also we don't see that span, okay, that's why it got error at this point and it was not able to continue. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll put a condition that if the count of the results given by query selector is greater than 0, only then print this price, otherwise don't do or don't try to fetch the inner text of it. So I add a if block here, if elements I dot query selector, again the same locator, span dot price, product price, and I need to evaluate the length of it, so dot length, if this length is greater than 0, only then try to fetch the inner text and print on console. So greater than equals 0 and then this statement. Okay, and I also add a else block here that if it is not finding that price value for the block, in that case just write not found or something like that, so that we can print the right price value for all the elements in the Excel when we will be copying the results. So console.log again in the else block, and you can print any string here. Now when we run it, we'll get all the prices, and there is still one issue where you can see on the left side of the price there are some numbers present in the blue color, which is 2, 3 somewhere. It actually happens whenever two consecutive or multiple consecutive lines of the console log have same content. So what it does is it only prints once and it just increments the counter. Okay, but this is not correct for our logic. It should actually print all the prices correctly, because when you try to adjust here in your Excel sheet, you won't be getting all the 500 prices because all the consecutive duplicates are eliminated. So that's why you won't be getting the correct prices. Alright, so you can check here, we have got 480 something. So I'll show you in the logs again, you see 2 here for 8.54, that means there were 2 consecutive 8.54. And similarly, you can see 32.50, again 2. That means 2 elements have same prices, but it shows only 1. So we need to make the string unique actually, so that it prints all the price values. Now, this was the code. How can we make our string unique? It is very simple. You can just concatenate the index value, which is I, which is incrementing for every element. So you can later remove it. So I am just incrementing. I am just putting this I, and then I put equals as a separator and then the value. Now the same code with just a value of I along with it, when I run this you would see it now prints all the values with their index numbers. Now it is very easy for me to copy and paste in Excel, and then I can easily remove the indexes from Excel using text to columns. I can use a separator as equals, and then I can use only second column value. Right, so just select the column, use text to columns, put delimiter as equal, and then hit OK, and you would be having index in the first column and the price value in the second column, and then you can use the second column value. Alright, so this is how you can get all the correct prices for all the items. The intent for this video was not to explain to you data scraping using JavaScript, because in earlier videos also I have explained this concept, but the intent was to explain to you certain challenges that we face while doing actually real data scraping on a real project. So if I give you a quick recap of the problems that we have solved in this tutorial, one was the query string parameter, where we had results in multiple pages but we were able to sort out on one page only, right? And we eliminated a lot of scripting to get the data, right? Second problem statement was when we have multiple logs with same values, how can we match accordingly? And third one was when text or inner text is not giving you the correct values, look for other properties. Alright, I'll see you in the next tutorial with more such interesting tips. Thank you. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon.